Good morning, I'm Eric Scott. This is New Jersey's First News for Tuesday, August 22nd. It's made possible by the Bet Parks Casino and Sportsbook app. We're going to have a very nice day today, very summer-like in the Garden State, not quite as warm and lower humidity. And our chief meteorologist, Dan Zero, says we've got a couple of nice days ahead, already starting to turn our attention towards the weekend. Full forecast details are available on air, online at nj1015.com and on our free mobile app. The New Jersey Forest Fire Service is reporting significant progress overnight containing a large forest fire at Wharton State Forest. It's near Atco Dragway in Waterford Township, 75% contained this morning. 1,500 acres have burned. The fire first broke out on Sunday afternoon. Crews have been focusing on moving the blaze close to where their equipment can contain it. No injuries have been reported, no evacuation orders, and no structures are being affected at this time. It has been a far less rowdy summer down the shore this year than in past years. The number of warnings and summonses given out for things like underage drinking and loud gatherings way down in most towns. Many local officials credit stricter curfews for the changes. A spokesman for Cape May, for example, told NJ.com police gave 17,000 curbside warnings last year. This year, there have only been 7,000, and many other shore towns are reporting similar numbers. The Internal Affairs Division of the Westfield Police Department now investigating a traffic stop. It is a stop that may have been triggered by a driver flipping off a cop. Video of the stop has gone viral on social media, where the driver alleges he was pulled over for a bogus speeding infraction after giving cops the Jersey salute. Legal experts agree, and courts have held, flipping off a cop is protected free speech. The driver was ultimately given a ticket for careless driving. The Westfield police chief confirmed a review of the entire incident is underway. A Middlesex County nurse is now prison bound. This follows a drunken wrong-way crash that killed two boys and hurt two police officers and a civilian. Prosecutors say Yokari Batista Alcantara was drunk and using her cell phone late on Thanksgiving 2021 when her Honda Accord went the wrong way down an on-ramp in North Brunswick, hitting an Old Bridge police cruiser. The crash killed 2 9-year-olds, which other sources ID'd as the driver's son and a relative, while also hurting those two officers. Nicotine exposure in young kids is becoming a bigger problem in New Jersey. And the experts say it is because of the number of individuals who are using vaping devices. New Jersey has already seen the same number of cases this year that we saw all of last year. The liquids that are used in nicotine vapes can make children very sick. In high enough doses, toxic exposure can be fatal, so keeping the products out of the reach of children is key. Another iconic New Jersey diner is now up for sale. This is the Blairstown Diner on Route 94, listed for $675,000, the current owner hoping to retire. The Blairstown Diner is perhaps best known for being featured in multiple scenes in the 80s slasher film Friday the 13th. The town of Blairstown also featured in that classic horror flick. And there's an opportunity today for you to get some free Jersey Fresh peaches. They're going to be given away at three locations down the shore, including Wildwood and Atlantic City. A full list of where and why you're getting them today at nj1015.com. Have something to say about our top stories? Leave your comments right here. Please like and share this video. And remember, we're always taking your calls, talking Jersey on air on New Jersey 101.5. I'm Eric Scott. That's New Jersey's First News for this Tuesday, August 22nd. It's made possible by the Bet Parks Casino and Sportsbook app. Have a great day.